Hello everybody, welcome to Word Shard.
Today we are going to continue with Merchant of Venice, and we already have completed Act 1 Scene 1 and Act 1 Scene 2. In Act 1 Scene 1, we came to know about the famous merchants. First, the important character Antonio and Bassanio, we come to know about them. In the first scene, we also come to know that Bassanio wanted to go to Belmont, where he wanted to meet Portia and win her in the way of marriage. In the second scene, we come to know about Portia, who lives in Belmont, whose father has died just a little time back, and she is given to marry somebody when that person is able to choose the correct caskets. There are three caskets: the gold casket, silver casket, and lead casket. The one who chooses the correct casket gets to marry her. These are the first two scenes. We see that many of her suitors are going back because they do not want to follow the conditions which are associated with the casket choice. And lastly, we find that Prince of Morocco. Morocco is a place in Africa. From there also a suitor has come to her. Okay. Now, in this side of the play, what do we see? In Venice, where Antonio and Bassanio were talking, there we find that Bassanio is preparing to go to Belmont. Antonio did not have enough money to give to him. He required 3,000 ducats and he did not have that much money. So, he told Bassanio to use his name in the market so that he can raise the money from the market. Now, another person who was very rich at that point of time was Shylock. Shylock is a Jew. This is another important fact that we are going to talk in Merchant of Venice. It is a clash between, it is a, you know, a cold war between the Christians and the Jews. Jews are another, a few of people who believed in a different religion. So, they are the Jews, and there is always a clash between the Christian and the Jews. We will find it in the third scene. This is the third scene, where we meet another important character. What is the name of that character? Shylock. He is also another merchant, but the problem is he is a Jewish merchant and he has become very rich. So that the Christians does not want to accept. You know, money gives you a lot of power. Now Shylock, although he is a Jew, although the Christians wanted to dominate the Jews, Shylock had earned a lot of money through his business and therefore the Christians hated him a lot. Now, Shylock was a moneylender. Who is a moneylender? Moneylender is a person. For example, if I want 3,000 rupees and I do not have that much money in my house, then I will go to a person. Maybe nowadays we go to the bank. We take a loan from the bank. For example, I need 3,000 rupees. I don't have it. So, I go to the bank and I take that amount of money. And I will have to, because the bank is helping me when I need the money, I also have to give something to the bank in return. What will I give? Every month, I will have to pay the bank maybe a particular amount of money, maybe 10 rupees per month. So, when I am returning the whole amount after 3 or 4 months, then 3000 plus the 10 rupee of every month. Maybe I have borrowed the money for 4 months, then 4 into 10, 40 rupees are added to this whole money. That means 3040 rupees I have to return to the bank. Why do I need to give this 40 rupees extra to the bank? Because you see, the bank has helped me when I needed the money. That is why. Now, Shylock was a money lender who used to lend money to people when they required it. Now Bassanio has come to Shylock because Shylock is very rich. Shylock has that much of money to give to Bassanio because Bassanio required the money. He required it urgently. Immediately he required the money, and there was nobody else in that place who could give him that amount of money, and therefore they had to come to this Jew. Although they did not want to come to him, yet they had to, because Shylock was a very rich person. Just after Antonio, Shylock was another rich person in Venice. So enter Bassanio and Shylock. We will see what happens over here. Shylock. 3,000 ducats. What are ducats? See, here is a picture of a ducat. This is a Venetian gold coin. What do you mean by Venetian? Venetian means the gold coins which were used in Venice. So, how much money does Bassanio require? He requires 3,000 ducats. Bassanio. Ah, yes. Sir, for 3 months. For how many months does he require the money? For 3 months. I means yes. Shylock, for 3 months. Well, so Shylock says that okay, you require 3,000 ducats for 3 months. Well, Bassanio, for the which, as I told you, Antonio shall be bound. Bound means Antonio will be the guarantor. Antonio is going to give guarantee to this that if Bassanio is unable to pay 3,000 ducats back to Shylock, then Antonio will be questionable for that. Then Antonio will have to pay the 3,000 ducats because nobody will believe in Bassanio. We already know Bassanio is a spendthrift. He does not have any money with him at all. He spends everything. So nobody will believe in Bassanio. Therefore, if Bassanio is unable to pay the amount back, then Antonio will pay. Okay. Shylock, Antonio shall become bound. Well, so Shylock again repeats, okay, so if you are unable to pay, then Antonio will guarantee that my money will be back. Antonio will pay me the money. Okay, that's the case. Bassanio, may you steed me? What do you mean by steed? See, all those difficult words are written in red as we always do in our class, isn't it? So, may you steed me means, would you help me? I require the money. Would you help me? Will you pleasure me? Pleasure means, would you oblige me? You remember when we write letters, formal letters, we write, I'll be obliged if you help me. Just like that. I'll be very obliged. I'll be very happy if you help me. Shall I know your answer? That means, what is your answer? Do you want to help me? Shylock, 3,000 ducats for 3 months and Antonio bound. So, Shylock again repeats the same thing. Bassanio, your answer to that. So, Bassanio asks, yes, what is your answer? Do you want to help me or do you not want to help me? Shylock, Antonio is a good man. So, Shylock says that, okay, Antonio is obviously a good man. Bassanio, have you heard any imputation to the contrary? Imputation means, have you heard any allegation? Have you heard anything bad about Antonio? That Antonio never returns money that he has taken from somebody else. Have you heard anything like that? What does Shylock say? Oh, no, no, no. My meaning in saying he is a good man is to have you understand me that he is sufficient. So Shylock says, no, 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 no. My meaning in saying he is a good man is that I accept that he is sufficient. You have to understand that it is okay. Shylock is satisfied with the idea that Antonio will be bound. If Bassanio cannot pay, then Antonio will pay him the money. Antonio is obviously sufficient, isn't it? Sufficient guarantee because Antonio is a rich person and he will keep his word. He will obviously give him his money back. Yet, his means are in sub. Now, over here, you have to be careful. You have to remember the first scene. We see Antonio is a merchant. All his ships have gone to different directions to sell their goods and earn a lot of money. But at the present moment, he does not have enough money. So if there are a lot of risks, isn't it? If you go into the ship, you will understand that previously when there were sails and when there was a lot of, there was risk when you traveled in a ship. So there are risks. Now, facing those risks, if anything bad happens, then obviously what will happen is Antonio will become very poor. If in case Antonio's ship does not return, then what will happen? Antonio will become very poor. Antonio will not be able to pay me my money back. Okay. Yet his means mean business. Yet his means, that is his business, are in supposition. That means, although he is a rich man, his ships are enduring a lot of risk. All his ships are going out for business. Now all his money is invested in the ships. Now if his ships cannot return, then he will face a lot of loss. And then how will I get my money back? He hath an argosy. Argosy means ship bound to Tripoli. Tripoli is a place. It is a great channel of trade. Where does it take place? It goes to Central Africa. Another to the Indies. So he has a number of ships and all the ships are going to different places. One is going to Tripoli, one is going to Indies. Okay. I understand moreover upon the Rialto. Rialto is a place where the merchants met for transaction of business. Venice is a place where a lot of business used to take place. And Rialto is a place where the transaction used to take place, the money business used to take place in the Rialto. He had the third at Mexico. So you can be asked this question, where are all his ships? One is going to Tripolis, okay? One is going to Indies, number two. Number three, one is going to Mexico, and one has gone to England. And many other ships are going to different other places. So we can understand the person has so many ships, so he must be very rich. But all his ships are going to different places, and all his money is invested in the ships. He does not have much money in hand. So if the ships undergo a shipwreck, then he will be bankrupt. Okay. He had squandered abroad. So he has scattered all his money abroad. That means all his money is risked on the ships. Okay. But ships are but boards. But you see, ships are pieces of wood. So what does he mean by this? Ships are pieces of wood. Ships are but boards mean that any moment woods can break. There can be storms. There can be shipwrecks. And your ship will, you know, it will hit some rock and it will break into pieces. Then what will happen to my money? Then Antonio will become bankrupt. And how will I get my money back? Sailors but men. You see, sailors are just human beings. Sailors are not gods that they will protect the ships from any danger. There can be shipwrecks. Then who will protect the ship? The ship will drown. Then all my money will be lost. There be land rats and water rats. Water thieves and land thieves. Now, moreover, there are other problems also. For example, in the land, we see what? There are thieves, isn't it? There are land thieves. In the similar way, there are water thieves also. What do you mean by water thieves or water rats? They are pirates. Pirates are the ones who are the, they are like robbers on the sea. They come in a ship and they massacre your ship and they take away, they steal and they kill people and they take away everything from your ship. So they are like robbers on the sea. So there are these risks also. There are pirates also in the ship, in the sea. And then there is the peril. That means there are dangers of waters also. Waters, winds and rocks. There can be submerged rocks like you see in Titanic. Okay, if it hits a rock like that, if there is a strong wind, if there is a storm, okay, then what will happen? Then your ship can drown. The man is notwithstanding sufficient. Okay, I have a lot of faith in Antonio, but I don't believe that I have not much faith in this thing that if his ships will return, he will be able to pay me the money. The other way around can also happen. His ships may not return, then my money will be lost. So I have to think and make a wise decision. 3,000 ducats, I think I may take his bond. Okay, so 3,000 ducats you want. Okay, let me think. Be assured you may. I will be assured I may. This means Shylock says that, yes, I will obviously have to think. I have to make a wise decision. I just cannot give away money like that. I have to think whether it will be a good decision or not. And that I may be assured, I will bethink me. What do you mean by I'll bethink me? I'll think a number of times before I make such a decision of giving you the money. May I speak with Antonio? He asked that, can I speak to Antonio about it? Bassanio. If it please you to dine with us. Okay, so obviously we can talk. You can have, we can have dinner together. Then we can have a talk about it. We means over here Antonio, Bassanio and Shylock. So Bassanio invites him to dinner so that they can have food and talk about this business. I think I have been able to make myself clear up to this. Dine with us. Before we move to the next part, I will tell you that if you like my video and if you have any question regarding this, do comment in the comment section and tell me about your problems. You can also try the questions given in the Xavier Pinto book. And if you find any problem over there, you can also ask those questions in the comment section. Thank you so much. Now we'll move to the next part. See, Shylock. Yes, to smell pork. What happens just before this? Bassanio invites Shylock to dinner. Now Shylock says, no. It is not possible for me to smell pork. This yes is not a yes, normal yes. This is sarcasm. When you don't want to do something and you say, yes, now I will have to follow you and then fall into some problem. It is a sarcasm. So he does not want to go and eat with them. Why? Because their religion is different. They do not like pork, to smell pork. You know, the Christians eat a lot of pork, but the Jewish people does not. So he is not going to dine with that person. To smell pork, to eat of the habitation which your prophet, the Nazarite, conjured the devil into. What do you mean by Nazarite? Nazarite is Jesus Christ. I'll tell you a story over here. What happened is, there was a madman who was behaving in a very abnormal way. And then what happened is, Jesus Christ came and helped that man. How did he help him? It is said that that mad person was behaving in that way because a devil had got inside him. So what did Jesus Christ do? Jesus Christ took that devil out from the madman, from the madman's body, and then put that devil into the pigs. Okay, so what happens is, Shylock says, I'm not going to have pigs with you. Pork means pigs only. So I'm not going to have pigs with you because, you know, pigs are devil and we don't like pigs and we don't eat pigs. Conjured means order the devil into. So you have understood why they are talking about the, why Shylock is talking about the Nazarite. Nazarite, Jesus Christ had put the devil into the pigs, the bad soul into the pigs. That is why he is not going to have pigs with them. I will buy with you, sell with you, talk with you, walk with you, and so following. That means Shylock says, I will do everything with you, but I will not eat with you because they do not eat the same thing. Christians eat pigs and Jewish people does not. Drink with you, I will not drink with you, and nor pray with you. Why will they not pray with them? Because their religion is different. What news on the Rialto? Who is he comes here? Now somebody is entering the scene. Who is that person? Antonio is coming. Bassanio. This is sinner Antonio. Here is Antonio. And Shylock already wanted to talk with Antonio. Now Shylock talks aside. Aside means whatever Shylock is speaking, Bassanio or Antonio cannot hear it. Okay, wait, you talk in your mind, you know, sometimes, yes, yes, I have to do this. No, no, I cannot do that. Like that. He is talking aside means he, whatever he is speaking over here, Bassanio and Antonio cannot hear that. Okay. How like a fawning publican he looks. What do you mean by fawning? Fawning means somebody who shows too much love. You have seen, no? Antonio was very fond of Bassanio. He was so much in love with Bassanio that he could do anything and everything for him. So he is like a fawning publican. Publican means, publican is a word used over here to show how much Shylock hates Antonio. There are certain reasons why he hates Antonio. Now he is going to tell what are the reasons for which he hates him. This part is important. See, I hate him for he is a Christian. Firstly, though, he is a Christian. He has a different religion than ours. That is the reason number one. Second, more for that in low simplicity. Second, what is the reason? Second is he is very foolish. Antonio is extremely foolish according to Shylock. Why? Because he lends out money gratis. Gratis means free of interest. Antonio is a person who will give away money like anything. If you go and ask Antonio, will you give me 10,000 rupees? He will just give you. And he will not ask for any interest. You don't have to give some extra money for that. You will not have to pay anything to Antonio. He'll just give you 10,000 rupees. Now, what is the problem? He brings down the rate of usance here with us in Venice. Usance means money lending business. What is the business that Shylock does? It is money lending business. Imagine you go to borrow some money from a bank. You go to borrow 3,000 rupees from the bank. Now, bank will obviously charge interest. So you will have to pay 40 rupees extra when you give back, when you return the full money. You have to pay back 3,040 rupees. Okay. But let us take that there is another man who gives you money just like that. You go and ask him, he will give you 3,000 rupees. He will not charge interest. So where will you go? Will you go to the bank anymore? No, you will go to him only because he does not charge interest. Isn't it? That is why what is happening is the business, the banking business, the money lending business crashes because the interest rate will fall. If there is nobody to go and borrow money from that person, obviously his interest rate will fall, his business will collapse. So Antonio and his way of lending money to anybody and everybody without charging interest is also a reason for the downfall of Shylock's money lending business. Clear? So that is also the reason for which he is angry. So there are three reasons. Firstly, because of his simplicity, because of his foolishness, because he brings the rate of interest down in the money lending business. Second, he does not like Antonio because of his Christian religion. Okay. If I can catch him once upon the hip, now look at this picture. This is the emotion of Shylock. Shylock is very angry with Antonio because the reason for Shylock's business problems is Antonio. That is why his face is like this. He thinks, okay, now I have got Antonio in my grip and now I will take my revenge. If I can catch him once upon the hip, if I can catch him in a problematic situation once, then I will feed fat. Feed fat means I will fully satisfy my grudge. Ancient grudge means since a long time I have a lot of hatred accumulated towards him. Now I will satisfy my revenge. Okay. He hates our sacred nation. This is another reason why he does not like Antonio. See, he hates, that means he means Antonio also hates their sacred nation. That means the Jewish race. So the Christians, particularly Antonio, does not like the Jewish people. And he rails, that means he abuses even there where merchants most do congregate. That means in the Rialto, where all the merchants come and meet each other and talk with each other. Okay, foreign people also come at times. Now at that place, Antonio goes and humiliates Shylock. Talks rubbish about Shylock and his religion. Obviously, if somebody is talking bad about you, you will be angry with that person. So this is another reason for which Shylock does not like Antonio. Clear? On me, my bargains and my well-won thrift. Well-won thrift means he has a lot of quality of a businessman. He has earned a lot of money through his money lending business. So Antonio, what does Antonio do in the Rialto? He abuses Shylock. He abuses his profits that he has earned a lot of money. He abuses that also. He makes fun of Shylock's business also. Now, obviously, if so many things a person does against Shylock, Shylock will obviously be angry. Which he calls interest. Cursed be my tribe if I forgive him. So my race will be, my people, the Jewish people will be angry with me if I do not take revenge. Now, at this point of time when Antonio has come to me to borrow money, this is the time, this is my advantageous position when I can take my revenge. Okay, this is a very interesting scene. Soon you will understand why I call it an interesting scene. Let's continue. Bassanio, Shylock, do you hear? So Bassanio calls Shylock. Shylock is continuously thinking about all the good times that is going to come. He is going to take revenge upon Antonio and he is lost in his thoughts like this smiley. Okay, so Shylock, do you hear? Shylock, I am debating, that means I'm calculating my present store. How much money I have now, I'm calculating that. Because I have to give you 3,000 ducats. And by my near guess of my memory, I cannot instantly raise up the gross of full 3,000 ducats. So he says that at present, the amount of money that I have is not 3,000 ducats, is less than 3,000 ducats. But what of that? Tubal, a wealthy Hebrew of my tribe, Hebrew means another Jew. He is a friend of mine. What is the name of Shylock's friend? Tubal. So Tubal, who is another Jew, will furnish me. That means my Jewish friend will give me the rest of the money. A little bit I have and I will add up some money of Tubal's also and then I will lend the full amount to you. But soft. Soft means not soft. What you mean by soft, it is not the same as that. Soft over here means wait. How many months do you desire? Okay, so how many months you desire? Now, why is he constantly asking the same question? Because he wants to show Antonio and Bassanio that you have come to me like a beggar asking for money. You should understand that every time you cannot insult me, you need me also. At this point of time, you have come to me to borrow money from me and you require my help. And it is my choice to help you or not. Okay? So to Antonio, rest you fair, greet, fair means it is a greeting, good signor. Your worship was the last man in our mouths. What do you mean by your worship was the last man? That means I was just, we were, that means I and Bassanio were just now talking about you. Your worship is a kind of respectable way of speaking. Okay. Antonio, Shylock, although I neither lend nor borrow by taking nor by giving of excess. So Shylock, Antonio says that, see, I don't borrow or lend money like that. I just give it to anybody and everybody. I don't borrow money also. But to supply the ripe, ripe means the immediate desire or want of my friend, because my friend needs the money immediately, I will break a custom. So I will obviously have to lend money from you. Otherwise, I would not have come to you. But because Bassanio requires the money immediately and I don't have that much money, that is why I have come to you for help. Is he yet possessed? That means, is he aware of how much ye would? That means, how much you want? Does Shylock know that? I 3,000 ducats. So Shylock says, yes, I know the amount, Antonio. And for 3 months. Okay, 3 months. I forgot, 3 months. You told me so. Again, he is repeating the same thing for the same reason. Well, then your bond, and let me see. But hear you, methought you said you neither lend nor borrow upon advantage. So, but again, Antonio, Shylock goes on saying this, that I thought, methought means I thought, you said you neither lend nor borrow upon advantage. So you just told me that you don't lend or borrow money and you don't charge interest on anything, or you don't like to pay interest. Neither do you lend money with interest, nor do you borrow money for interest. Okay, so I think that part is right. So we will keep up to this and it will be continued in the next class. I hope I have been able to explain you well. If it is clear to you, you can like, subscribe, and obviously share with your friends. Thank you so much, dear children.